Amazing Grace. We're going to sing Amazing Grace.
Robin? Yeah.
One, take one.
Can I have your attention, everybody, please? I would love everyone to focus, look to me. Let us come now to rest. It klinks amper soos 'n flea market. I want us to come to rest now. For this is a holy moment. We are saying now our final goodbye to a mother, to a grandmother, to a great-grandmother, a aunt, a sister, a neighbor, a child of the Almighty God. What a life. What a life, brothers and sisters, dear Biri family. You were spoiled by this great God for having a mom like this, having a grandmom like this, and a great grandmom. Because God, you know, when you put your hand in the glove can lay there, it's useless. But the moment you put your hand in it, you can do all the things. And that is what God did with Priscilla. He lived within her, with His spirit within her. And it's impossible for her to endure till this moment. But she did it only with the help of God. It is amazing to see and to experience and to know her reliance on the Almighty God. So now we come with reverence and we come with thanksgiving in our hearts. It's not easy to say goodbye. It's sad, it brings tears, it brings heartache. But the shortest verse in the Bible is Luke 11 verse 35. It says Jesus wept. Now let me tell you, Jesus never wept because Lazarus died. He loved Lazarus. He loved his sisters Martha and Mary. He's the only one that knew Lazarus must die. They didn't understand that. For they sent someone to go tell Jesus Lazarus is sick. Jesus answered for this person, the messenger. Go tell them Lazarus' sickness is not unto death, is unto the glory of God. Jesus knew, and the Father, his Father knew that Lazarus will die. He never told him yet that. It says he tarried in the city 2 days after hearing the news. The one that he loves, Lazarus, is sick. After 2 days, he told his disciples, Lazarus is dead. But now they can't understand. Now you want to go? Now that he's dead? It doesn't make sense. Hence we can't understand God. He said to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, Jesus the Christ, he shall live though they die. Though Marcella died, she lived. Because she lived in Christ when she was in the flesh. She lives in Christ now out of the flesh. She loved God. Her life is a testimony of it. We are witnesses of her faithfulness to God. And God's faithfulness unto her. But I want to come to the point. Now Mary say, if you would have been here, my brother would not have died. And then he tells her, don't worry. I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And those that die and still believe in me shall never die the second day. So now Mary comes. And Mary falls at his feet and Mary cries bitterly. And now I come to the point why Jesus wept. Jesus didn't weep because Lazarus died. He knew he's going to raise Lazarus out of the dead. Why should he cry about that? Let me tell you why he cried. When he looked to Martha and he looked to Mary and he saw their tears, he saw their sadness, he saw their grief, Jesus wept with him. Because Jesus feels our pain. Jesus feels our sorrow. Jesus knows the difficulty to say goodbye to mom. Jesus know how you feel as grandchild and great-grandchildren to say goodbye to ma, to a sister, to a friend. And he cries with us, for Jesus suffer with us. He's not apart from us. We don't serve a God that is a statue. We serve a God that is filled with love. And today we bring everything to him to say thanks be to God that have given us this beautiful gift in Marcella. We cry today, Lord, but we are filled with thanks and appreciation. Now it is our turn also to remain faithful to God. For you children, on the 21st of May, I recommend you arrange 6 children, 17 grandchildren, 14 great-grandchildren. You plan the 21st of May, we're going to come together and we're going to celebrate the birthday of our mother, out of gratitude to God for allowing us to have learned to know and to love her and to call her mom. Let's celebrate life. Let's appreciate one another while we are alive. Let us stop falling out over nonsense and be cross at each other for nonsense. Let's forgive. Let's embrace. For God loves us and wants us to live in harmony. Come, let us pray. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Great God and wonderful Father, Thou hast made us. Of all that Thou hast created, we human beings are the crown of Thy creation. Why Thou lovest so much, not even the devil know the answer, dear Lord. He can't fathom it. Why Thou love us sinners so much. But Father, we are thankful for loving us. Thankful for sending Jesus, our Savior, to die on the cross so that we may have access back to Thee, dear Lord. Thank you, Father. There's a future awaiting us, that our loved ones that died in Christ will rise again. It says, dear Lord, that in Thy Holy Scripture, the dead in Christ will rise and meet Thy Son on the cloud. Then us, who have remained faithful on earth, and together we will just embrace Thy Son Jesus, and we will come to Thee. If it occurs to Thee, dear Lord, and thank You, this is our desire. Come, Lord, come fetch us. But if Thou allow us still to remain, help us to remain faithful to God the Almighty and to Thy Son Jesus Christ, whom Thou hast sent. Help us to concentrate on that which is godly and not so much on that which is temporal, dear Lord. And help us to appreciate each other. For we hear now, the next moment we're gone, and then we don't want to have regret. Thank You for allowing the Lord, this Williams family, all of them, the opportunity to say their goodbyes. Thank You, dear Lord. We know it is utter abundant mercy. Once again, bless Thy son Clive in hospital. Please, Lord, let our prayers, let him may feel it. Let it may bring him health and bring him home again. Now, dear Lord, we want to do the committal. Ashes to ashes. Earth to earth. And dust to dust. Soul and spirit, however, I commend unto the care and love of our Lord Jesus Christ, who will guard over it until His return. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen. Let us do the benediction. The grace of Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the comforting fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.